So God will find us. Wherever we are, God will find us. But we are living in a time, and Genesis chapter 6 tells us, verse 4, there were giants in the earth in those days. And also after that, when the sons of God came in unto the daughters of men, and they bare children to them, saying, came mighty men, which were of old, men of renown. And God saw that the wickedness of man was great in the earth, and that every imagination of the thoughts of his heart was only evil continually. And it repented the Lord that he had made man on the earth. And it grieved him at his heart. And the Lord said, I will destroy man whom I have created or made on earth. And I will destroy him from the face of the earth, both man and beast and the creeping thing, the fowls of the air, for it repented me that I have made them. But Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord. Go down to verse 11, and it says, the earth also was corrupt before God, and the earth was filled with violence. And God looked upon the earth, and behold, it was corrupt, for all flesh had corrupted his ways upon the earth. And God said unto Noah, the end of all flesh is come before me, for the earth is filled with violence through them, and behold, I will destroy them with the earth. I want you to go quickly with me to Matthew chapter 24. Matthew chapter 24. The first chapter of the New Testament is compared with the first chapter of the Old Testament. Or the first book of the New Testament is compared with the first chapter of the Old Testament. And if you add 4 and 2, 24 chapter, you'll get 6. You can make a lot of other similarities to show that God is the author of wisdom. And we go to verse 37. But as the days of Noah were, so shall also the coming of the Son of Man be. For as in the days that were before the flood, they were eating and drinking, marrying and giving in marriage until the day that Noah entered into the ark, and knew not until the flood came and took them all away, so shall also the coming of the Son of Man be. My topic this morning is, so shall it be. So shall it be. This morning, what I am giving you is fair warning. That before you use your restroom to refresh yourself, or what the police call to answer a call of nature, there's copious warning in the body that tells you that you have to do something. When a woman is pregnant. The baby just don't drop out. There's warning, or there are warning signs, which tells her that something is going to happen soon. Whenever there is going to be rain, the Bible tells us that you look in the west and the clouds are in the west, and you know that you're going to have rain. When the sky is red in the evening, you know you're going to have poor weather. When the sky is red in the morning, the Bible tells us that you know that you're going to have good weather. These are what we call signals to put us on our guard. Before the car bucks into another car, there's a screech, screech! And then brown. There's a warning. You get a warning that fire is somewhere, or someone has been killed by the sign and the sounds of wailing horns and sirens of the police car, the ambulance, or the fire engine. I'm going to make this real for you now. And so we get out of the way. Some of us get out of the way. There's a warning light between red and green. It's called a warning light to tell you the next one is red. And if you go through, you're going to be in serious trouble. These are warning signs. Jesus tells us that I am going, but I am coming again. When I come again, I am coming to receive you unto myself, that where I am, there you may be also. But there is a time that will be ushered into this system, which one writer called cataclysmic. It's cataclysmic in that it is going to bring in huge sufferings and tragedies. There are going to be a lot of losses. Man is going to be so debased in their outlooks and in their thinking that they don't want to keep God in their thinking. I'm going to get to this way right now. I've been to the hotel, the wife and I were at rest. We tried to find a gospel channel. I'm talking about Reggae and Nassau, Sandals. Huh? Reasons. We could not find one channel with God in it where you could get away from God. They have X'd God out of the hotels in the Bahamas. They have X'd God out. We went to the States. We live in La Quinta, in Deerfield. We flipped through the channels, looking for someone to give us a word or hear from God. We couldn't find one channel in that hotel. You couldn't pay for one that talked about God. Deerfield has ex-God out of their hotel. Why? Because they are pampering and catering to a people who do not want to hear anything about God. They don't want to hear anything that will challenge or cause them to have a second thought about their lifestyle. While they live together as husband and wives, and they're not man and woman, they don't want to hear God telling them that. Then the robber who just robbed the bank or who's smoking his grass don't want to hear anything about God. So they tell them, we don't want that stuff in the hotel. That's cramping our style. And the Christians are not, they're silent. I think that's discrimination. In fact, I think that's rank discrimination against a segment of society. Because to not put it there is just as bad as putting it there. So those who want to hear it, it's good for them. It's not good for them. But those who don't want to hear about God, having no God gospel in the hotel, is good for them. But for those of us who want to hear about God, it's bad for us. That is a sign. That is a sign of the time in which we are living in. When we hear right here in our country, over 100 murders, live 5 years old, get shot. This is a sign of the time. When people believe that it's okay, that there's nothing wrong with you, if you decided that you're going to adopt a woman behavior when you are a man, something wrong with you. The devil in you. You have a devil that ahead of you. And you need to get that devil out. You should laugh at it. Hallelujah. See, people don't hear the truth. The Bible said, as it was in the days of Noah, so shall it be in the days of the coming of the Son of Man. It would be more valuable than Sodom and Gomorrah. You know the story of Sodom and Gomorrah? Well, all of this, me and my wife being in our children, sit down with our children, and these two men, they got a boy with Down syndrome and a regular girl, and they're there, one got it like this, and the next one, one is a woman, one is a man, and I say, what kind of, and the little one with the Down syndrome, he's beginning to adopt the woman behavior. That's not of God! I don't care what nobody say. I don't care whether they shut me out or shut me down. I go in now. Yeah, that is not of God. If you're doing it, you gotta stop. Yeah. Because heaven is a holy place.
Yeah.
It's filled with glory. Yeah. And with grace. Yeah. No sin down there. Yeah. We say, well, that ain't the only sin. No, that is not the only sin. But that's an unnatural sin. Thieving is just as bad. Yeah. This is what they've been doing in the days of Noah. They were stealing and they had no conscience. They didn't thought anything was wrong with it. That's the danger. People accepting this thing as right. It's not right. It's not right to steal. To take from another person when it's not theirs. That's wrong. It's not right to be married and commit adultery of another one on the side. That's wrong. Yeah. Now whether I do it or not, whether you do it or not, it's wrong. And we need to stop. Yeah. Fornication, you ain't married. any year you would, you got more children than a married woman. That's wrong. Fornication is wrong. That's what they've been doing in the days of Solomon and Gomorrah, because everybody said, "Well, child, let us some people own business. You can't preach that because nobody can come to the church." Well, guess what? The church is a place where you come to hear these things, and if you ain't well here, then you ain't need to be in the church.
Amen.
You know what, child? What do you come to church for? Just to come? Say, "Oh, we had a good time," and that's it. No, baby, that ain't what it is. Fornication and adultery, not what to talk. Witchcraft. People are wicked witchcraft. People think it's only, I'm naming you what it was in the days. People are actually working witchcraft. In other words, they stay up and they conspire to harm people. They're trying to cast a spell on you. They don't want to see a marriage work. They don't want to see a business work. They don't want to see a church work. They don't want to see nothing work. But let me tell you, you can stop a business. You can stop a marriage. But you can't stop the church. Jesus said, "Upon the rock, I will build the church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it." And guess what? If you stay in God, your husband stay in God, your marriage got to work. Listen to me. You know, it come in a time when you could be like Noah. All of Noah's family jumped ship. Every last one, except the three sons, the wife, and their wives. Everybody else who lived in that world said, "Noah gone nuts." Nobody associated with Noah. You can be no on your job. When you stand up for God, you will be no. But you can also have the no attitude and the no's hope and the no's faith, knowing that God will not say something if he's not prepared to back up what he's saying.
Hallelujah.
And debauchery. If you watch Noah, you will see that he had a well made up mind. So you've got to have a well made up mind. I want to let you know this morning that one with God is the majority. One of you will put 1,000 to flee. Son of the National only got the 6,000 Quakers, and he got that much. So directly, you'll be running from Son. People of God are going to be running from Son, and they're going to say, "God, I am depend on you. Feed me like how you feed Elijah." The Bible said, it's not like I'm going from point A to point B. God said, the Bible said, "Noah sat in Sodom and it grieved his righteous soul." We reach the stage where, as a Christian, you will live in a state where God was in that time of Noah, when it grieved God. Coming to the heart of it now. It said it grieved the Lord. The man is sorry. He was in distress. God, sorry. Yes, he has feelings. He loves. He cares. He's gracious. He's merciful. He's long-suffering. He cares. And I hear God saying this morning, "Come out! Come out from among them! And be you separated!" You better come out from among them. When you see people heading down a bad road, that road, if God didn't take you up that road, don't jump out on that road. The Bible said the word of God is not in word only, but it is in power. It's not in meat and drink. Some people believe that godliness is riches. Ah, I got more money than their money. I live long enough to realize that money ain't nothing. Money cannot get you anywhere. And all money can do is give you more sorrows and heartaches. Guess what? The more you get, the more space you need. One time your closet was this big, and you had 5 suits, and everything was well. I had on this suit for 3 Sundays now, and you're not even going to take it. The more money you get, the more problems you have. You need to worry about who can come rob you. You can need to know where you're going to put the money. You can know your check. I got a check on my thing to see if nobody's siphoning something off. Honey, the best thing for you all to do is to listen to what I'm saying and seek the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. Seek the Lord while he may be found. I say, seek the Lord. Upon him. One, he is near. Let the wicked forsake his words. An unrighteous man his thoughts. This is time for the people of God to become serious with the things of God. Because I hear God saying, behold, I come quickly. And my reward is with me. Not talking about all these things in the world. Big house, big car, fancy cars. Doesn't matter. I heard a girl say to another girl, I don't know why daddy and mommy don't get their act together. They was fighting over this house for 6 years. And daddy always saying, man, your mommy unreasonable. Your mommy could bargain and your mommy this. And she said, daddy, I'm not into that. I want to live. I want to be happy. And your mommy just keep fighting over this old piece of house. What's the big deal with all this materialism? We can die. For it is appointed unto man once to die, and after death cometh the judgment. Okay, the soul. Well, I love it, Pastor. I is one of them. If I love it, I can let it kill me. And ain't nobody can change my mind when I make up my mind. You stubborn. My advice for you this morning is to look at the days of Noah. What happened in the days of Noah? They were married and divorced. Hallelujah, Jesus. The devil. It's the devil, you know. It's the devil behind all of this. You know what they said? They said they believed that the information which we are now taking for granted, vis-a-vis the World Wide Web, man shuttled on the moon, man out of space, man have gone beyond this universe that we know and is into a place where they call the black hole. And the man who was engineering the research was a man who was paralyzed from head to toe, and the only thing was working was his brains. know about what's going on that we do not know about? Why is it that it's so necessary for a constituency of people that has grown by leaps and bounds into millions? Come on, y'all. They call it conspiracy theories. And they call themselves by a certain name. Hallelujah. Extraterrestrial beings, the sons of God, came down and intermarried with the daughters of men. And they became men of renown. Of renown. The doctor. I forget his name, who was the mastermind behind the spacecraft and the atomic bomb. In 1967 around there, he refused to participate any further with the program, and he joined himself with private enterprise. He died. And all on his graveyard was, at 61, he died. And all on his graveyard was this. Psalms 119, verse 1. This man, who it was who said to them, we're going to take man into space. And he did. On his tombstone, Psalms 19, verse 1. The earth declares the glory, the heavens declare the glory of God, and the firmament showeth forth his handiwork. Hallelujah. That's all they say about this man. But you see, word of faith. God is calling all of us. To make our calling an election sure. The word of God, David said, is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my pathway. Yes. David said, thy words are my hid in mine heart that I may not sin. Why are you doing all this sin? Why? Because everybody talking all kind of craziness. You go on Facebook and you see all kind of Christian pastors. Everybody's a pastor on Facebook. Ain't I right about it? Everybody got a word. Everybody posted up this. And Jesus, and this picture look good. And you see Jesus say amen. All kind of. Everybody's a pastor. Watch their lives. They live like the devil in hell. Don't you know that Satan knows the word of God too? I'm getting ready to close. Satan knows the word. If David, the son of God, jumped down from here, for it is written, he shall give his angel charge concerning thee. And in his hands they will bear you up, lest thou dash thy foot against a stone. But Jesus said, Satan is also written, thou shalt not tempt. Hallelujah. The Lord thy God. So there's a lot of word out there. And everybody, you want to know how sanctified they are, you just say something on their post and they tell you, you get out of my life. You're in my life and you're out of my life, and they blink, and there's something they do to you and you carry nothing else they post. I got to learn how to do that. But they X you out. You don't see nothing no more because they X you out. Because you want to tell them about how to live in Christ. We got to live in Christ. If you want Christ to live in you, you got to be in Christ. For the Bible said, if any man be in Christ, hallelujah, it's a mystery. If any, y'all, you looking at me this morning. If any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. Yes. If you're in Christ, you're a new creature. The old things are passed away. Behold, all things are You can't just be in Christ and doing devil things. Come on, man. Come on. You want me to jump in that dust? They want you to take off your clothes, your spiritual garment, and say one for the money, two for the show, and three get ready, and four to go in that day. Bear off with it, and then when you get up, you go around and say, well, they sanctify your old dirty clothes when you're torn, you grow up, and you come to church, and the only thing you can do is sing the songs of Zion. Hallelujah. I'm getting ready to stop. I'm not going to stop till the Lord tells me stop, because guess what? Something is going to happen in this nation that can make people's head turn. The boys say, and they don't give us no job. Man, we are wrong. Well, the only thing that happened is that when you go rob someone, they're going to take you out. Because they're going to be waiting for you to come and talk, but they're going to rob. And then they're going to say, you coming to rob me? Blam! You're gone? You think we have trouble now? You all got to wait. Let me tell you, I can't even preach Leviticus, the book of Leviticus, and tell the people what God said. Jeremy, don't worry about the mic today. Thank you, Brother Jeremy. Listen to me. Leviticus say you shouldn't even pierce your body. Pierce your body and write all kind of inscription on your body. Listen to me. People gone so far. I said this in Sunday school, but since you're only being here, I'll say it again. They got a ring in their mouth, on their tongue. My God, I don't know how to swallow that thing on their tongue. They got a ring on their tongue. I need a tongue examination in here. Who got a tongue examination? Time for a tongue examination. People got a ring on their navel. Ring in their ears. Ring in their nose. On their lip. On the eyebrow, and someone said, they got them. Listen, we got a son of God. My God. We are living in trying time. Yes. That's why I tell you all, do not put those tattoos on your skin.
No.
What are you marking up your skin for? Listen, tattoos were good as a means of identification during the wartime. They tattooed their skin during the wartime as a means of identification, and they were specific in what they did. Then here come the devil. And he said, man, look here, we can tattoo your whole body. And let me tell you, I see some old men who were young with a tattoo, and now everything fall down on them. They look like a scarecrow. They look like something wrong with them. But let me tell you, baby, you don't need to put no marking on them other than the mark of God. You need to see, all the devil is saying, get ready for the number 666. You don't need any marks on you. And every time I preach, people say, Rev, you need to get with it. I'm not getting with anything anymore. I'm not going to be a part of this world anymore. I approve God.
Yeah.
Guess what? If God can't do it, I don't want it.
Yeah.
I don't want nothing that is not of God.
Amen.
I don't want to see nothing that is not holy. When I say that, I'll see it, but I'm not going to participate in it. We got to live with expectation. Someone say expectation.
Expectation.
I'm closing now. Too much violence in the earth. We got to live with expectation.
Amen.
Too much corruption in this earth. I hear God saying, you're all going to school?
Yes, sir.
Go to school to learn.
Amen.
Not to have boyfriend. Go to school to learn your lesson, not to look for boyfriend. the end of the day, you do not have to be looking to any man for a handout. You don't have to go and desecrate yourselves. Put your trust in God. Stay chaste. Lift up that standard for Jesus. You know what God said? If I, Jesus said, if I be lifted up from the earth, I will draw all men unto me. We got to prove God, man. Time for us to prove God. We prove everything. But we don't approve God. We put our trust in everything else except God. Get on your knees. Daniel saw me the other day. He was off. Daniel was with me. God bless him. I go into the closet. He didn't know I was in there. He looked up and helped me. But I was in the closet. Hey, Daddy, what you doing in there? Daddy, I've been looking all around for you, man. Daddy, you like to talk American. See, Daniel, I was in the closet. What you doing in the closet, man? I said, Jesus said, go into your closet and pray. In your closet, close the door behind you. And when you pray in secret, he said, I will reward you openly. Yes. And I literally believe that. Uh-huh. So when I go into my difficult times, I go in my closet. Yes. Hallelujah. Yes. When I come in my closet, I know it is well.
It is well.
The writer said, run peace like a river. Yes. Attendeth my way.
Yes.
When sorrow, like sea, whatever my lot, thou hast taught me to say, it is well. Though friends may forsake me, it is well. When they scandalize me, it is well. I came here this morning to tell you, it's well with my soul. Hallelujah, it's well. I'm going to see Jesus for myself.
Yes.
I'm going to look upon his face.
Yes.
There to live forever.
Yes.
By his saving grace. Oh, to see your glory, let me lift my voice. Here's who I'm passing and who I'm last. Yes. Hallelujah. Yes. Ever to rejoice. I'm glad this morning.
Yes.
Sure. I'm glad this morning that I'm accounted the cost. I'm glad.
Go ahead.
This morning.
Oh, Jesus.
I'm glad. I don't know about you. You need to be glad too. But it ain't not gonna happen until you get serious about God. My final point. Hear God saying, what is it that you hold so dear to your heart, that pushes him out of it? What is it that you, that is still sinful, that you're struggling with? I'll be the first to tell you. It's a struggle myself.
Yes.
But I learned something. I don't want to struggle anymore. If I don't want it, I don't need to struggle.
Yes.
If I reject it, I don't need it.
No.
You can't charm me with something that I don't want.
Go ahead.
You can't make me interested in something that I don't care about.
Go ahead.
So I don't shall dare to sin. Hallelujah. You got to die to sin. And you got to be alive to God. Let this mind be in Christ in you, which was also in Christ Jesus. You got to let God's mind be in you. Oh, I wish I had a church.
Hallelujah.
When you let God's mind be in you, you ain't gonna be saying, oh no, but we are talking with me. We are picking on me. Me? I am a servant of the living God. Yeah. I preach in here, I preach out there. And I never compromise the word. Okay. Even if it's for me. Because when I go and I listen to the word myself, I end up crying. I say, Lord, you mean that's what you've been saying? And I began to walk, to try to walk the straight and narrow. Young man, I call you. I'm closing. Young man, I call you because you are strong. Old man, I call you because you know the way. You know what the Bible says as I close? Wherewithal shall a young man cleanse his ways. Wherewithal shall a younger man cleanse his ways? But by taking heed according unto the word of God. Psalms 119 verse 9. Psalms 119 verse 89 tells us, forever, O Lord, thy word is settled in heaven. You can't do nothing with the word of God. You can't do nothing with it. But Jesus said, heaven and earth shall pass away, but my word shall last forever. Hallelujah. Hold on to Jesus' word of faith. Hold on to Jesus. If you trust him, oh, never doubt him. God will not fail you. God will not fail you. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen.